Beautiful day they had yesterday for that Easter egg hunt.
You're telling me it was great. Mid-60s in Louisville yesterday. How about that?
I love it.
Not bad. We actually clipped 66 for high temperature at the airport, to be exact. Mm-hmm. Today, I think we're going to get to about 54 degrees for our high temperature. Regardless, though, Kentuckiana will be in the 50s this afternoon. Live look downtown. We're hanging out in the 40s in most areas. That sunrise right around 7:50 in the morning. We're waking up to 39 in Madison. And good morning to you in Scottsburg, one of the cooler spots at 37 right now. We do have a lot of low to mid 40s along Louisville and points south there. Paoli also sitting at 37. Early this morning. So again, we're going to easily rise to 54 degrees. That sunset getting pretty close to 8 p.m. So sunrise around 8 a.m. and that sunset around 8 p.m. We're going to be picking up quite a bit of sun all day today. We're actually sandwiched between two storm systems. We have one to the north, that counterclockwise flow around the low pressure center, bringing in some lake effect snow for our friends in western Michigan, as well as even far north and south as Chicago right now. We're not going to be seeing any kind of snow, maybe a flurry to the east tomorrow afternoon, but this cold front is dragging in that colder and dry air to the south of us. We also do have another storm system that will continue to veer its way to the south. Now, nationally, right now as it stands, our airports do not have any kind of issues. We'll be keeping you posted if there are some delays in any kind of airports nationally. Now, here's a close look at Futurecast. So, again, if you have an early flight this morning, maybe for St. Patrick's Day holiday, or hitting the roads, we're looking pretty good if you have travel plans to the north and west of us, as that high pressure is going to be continuing to shift its way in. But, again, the overall picture across the eastern seaboard calls for that cold front to be continuing to really march its way off to the east. And with it, both tomorrow and Tuesday will be staying dry. But notice that secondary little batch of cold air could be bringing in a spotty flurry, maybe some snow showers across the West Virginia and western Pennsylvania area. We're going to continue to stay very dry throughout the course of this whole week long. We have another front, though, sliding in that'll be bringing in the potential for a few more clouds here on Tuesday night into Wednesday morning. So again, today, climbing to the 50s in most areas. The reason I'm showing you this temperature and wind chill forecast tonight and tomorrow, this wind chill is the feels like temperature. That'll be in the 20s. The actual air temperature tonight in the low 30s. And again, tomorrow, even into the afternoon, we're still expected to see wind chills in the upper 20s, if not the 30 degree range throughout the course of the day tomorrow. So today or tomorrow will be kind of one of those days to stay bundled up for sure. Tonight, 31, clear and cold. Tomorrow, 44. Of course, today we'll be at 54. And yesterday we were in the mid 60s. So some colder air is starting to filter in. And then allergy report, keep in mind the pollen on the medium to high side of things. We're going to be watching that, of course. This colder air could be kind of helping with keeping the pollen in check, but we are going to be staying pretty dry, keep in mind. The next shot of rain won't be until Friday into possibly Saturday of next weekend, but that storm system looks to be a little bit weaker compared to the ones as of late. So we're going to be enjoying dry and fairly mild and seasonable temperatures all week long. Stick with us. We have more coming up. You're watching GMK This Morning.